We tell ourselves we are the world's greatest superpower, the world's most powerful military, and the greatest experiment in self-governance the world has ever known. We tell ourselves we're a bright city set high atop a hill, the defender of the weak, a refuge for the oppressed. And when you are all of those things, the strongest, the most powerful, the light for others to follow, the expectations are very high. Great nations embrace high expectations because the highest expectations of all are those we set for ourselves. We spent 20 years in Afghanistan, and it wasn't just the time invested. We invested $1 trillion of your money in Afghanistan. And then we invested that one resource for which there can never be a quantification, never be a measurement, never be a replacement, and that's the lives and limbs of our sons and daughters. And we invested all of that to protect ourselves against attacks, to send a message to those contemplating future attacks, and to provide compelling evidence to any who doubted our resolve. The message was supposed to be clear. We will do what it takes and stay as long as it takes to protect our country. That's what we invested so much time, money, and blood in Afghanistan for, to preserve our safety and our way of life. And that is what makes what is happening in Afghanistan so bitterly disappointing, and why so many Americans are angry at how this is unfolding. I want you to reflect on certain images, and usually there would be a warning here that the images you are about to see are disturbing. But just because something is disturbing doesn't mean we shouldn't see it. We should force ourselves to see these images. Because if we think the images are disturbing, what about the reality of actually living or dying through what is depicted in those images? Imagine what it would take for you to climb into the wheel well of an airplane. Your chances for survival are zero. You are simply choosing the manner in which you will die. You are choosing to die with this fleeting moment of freedom rather than being beaten or stoned to death. Can you feel the desperation required to hang on to the wheel of an airplane? The desperation required to leave your family and your friends, maybe forever, just to escape? Can you imagine a country where the streets are devoid of women and girls because they are too scared for their lives to appear in public? Can you imagine a country where your friends are targeted and beaten and killed simply and only because they are your friends? When you think of your investment, can you imagine a country where little boys can go to school, but not little girls? Can you think of a country where your religion can get you hanged? And what about the images of military equipment you developed and you built and you paid for being controlled by a group that stones women to death? The images do not match the reputation of our country. The images do not match the greatness of our country. The images do not match what we expect from ourselves. I mean, what's the use in being the world's greatest superpower if you can't stop women and children from being killed? And what's the value in being the strongest country on earth if you can't protect your friends? And what's the use of being the richest nation on earth when religious zealots steal what you own? And what's the value of being great if your friends and allies cannot trust your greatness? We were told Joe Biden was the most experienced person ever to hold the presidency on matters of foreign policy. We were told he was assembling a dream team that would guide America back to the forefront. We were told he was a steady hand who understood war and his cabinet would usher in a new era of American greatness. That's what we were told. And what we got was a group who failed to anticipate something as simple as the Taliban not keeping its word. And what we got was a flat-footed response with no contingency plan. And what we got was someone who ignored military advice. And what we got was one of the most embarrassing failures of America in our country's history. When Joe Biden became president, he made a point of telling the world that America is back, as if we had gone somewhere and he was Moses leading us out of the wilderness. And the media, of course, they fell for it. But others know better. Ask the people hanging on to the wheels of American planes. Ask the women and children being killed in the streets, and ask our allies and friends being tortured because they dared to take America at its word. Ask the Al-Qaeda or ISIS prisoners being freed from prison before Americans can even make it back home. Biden said America is back. Unfortunately, he was wrong. The Taliban is back. And America? Well, America is leaving. Leaving the women and children. Leaving those who believed in us. Leaving those who risked and gave their lives for us. America does not leave women, girls, children, our friends, or our fellow Americans behind, period. Greatness comes with a price. What we are seeing in Afghanistan is not American greatness. It's an American failure. It's America's decline. And that, too, comes with a price.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.